Fans, please turn your attention to the video boards and the field for our special halftime ceremony honoring Coach Tony Dungy.
But no excuses, no explanations. That was his first thing he told us. That was, you know, one of his Dungy-isms that I still live by today.
Working technique now. Okay. How we do it, not necessarily what we do, how we do it.
Tony changed everything. When he got here back in 1996, we had a long history of losing. He changed the culture in the building. He changed the culture in the locker room. The players had a new attitude, and it led to great things.
Tony had high expectations for you, but the best thing about him is that he didn't force those expectations on you. He just kind of, he laid them out there, let you be responsible, let you grow up, really. And if you did, you succeeded under him.
Anything you want to talk about, any situation, anything in life, he had an answer. And if he didn't, he had a path for you to find the answer. I guarantee you that.
Because you have heart, you got character, you got togetherness.
He was a guy of integrity and that wanted to have great character amongst his program and his team. He started developing that, and I think it was the perfect coach for us, for a young team with a lot of talent.
You just have to stay the course, and he was one guy that really believed in staying the course, that if we do these little things, that we're going to get to where we need to get to. So that's Bug Ball.
He became a reflection of Tony, just the way he approached the game. That's how we played football. You're going to line up against us on Sunday. You're going to know exactly what we're going to do, and we're still going to beat you.
Doesn't matter about stats. It doesn't matter about where we play, who we play. We play our game, we're going to win. And we're going to win a lot.
It goes back to the first team meeting, him making sure I understood that the game of football and how we play it under his leadership was to impact the community well beyond those 100 yards and those white lines.
Whatever it takes.
No excuses, no explanations.
Do what we do.
Act like a champion.
Be uncommon.
Tony Dungy arrived in Tampa in 1996 as a first-time head coach, and he immediately began the process of transforming the organization into a perennial playoff contender. Through his steady leadership, he guided the Buccaneers to playoff appearances 4 of the next 5 years, including a berth in the 1999 NFC Championship game. His legendary coaching career culminated with induction into the Pro Football Hall of Fame in 2016. And today, he joins John McKay, Malcolm Glazer, and John Gruden as the only non-players in the Buccaneers Ring of Honor. Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the east side of the stadium toward the south end zone as we unveil the 12th member of the Buccaneers Ring of Honor, head coach Tony Dungy.
Thank you, Gene. This is just a tremendous, tremendous honor. And I think back to 1996 when I came down to interview with the Glazer family. My wife, Lauren, and I prayed and we prayed and we prayed because we wanted to come down here. We felt this is where God wanted us. We got the job, and I remember the first meeting. I talked to the players and talked about what we wanted to accomplish. We wanted to win a Super Bowl. But more than that, we wanted to do it with the right kind of young men who would be role models for our community and people that our young folks could look up to. We didn't quite come through on that first goal, but we certainly did on the second one. As I look back and see all these guys who made it happen, I just can't tell you how proud I am of them. But I'm also proud of the Buccaneer organization, our fans, our city, and it's great to be part of this city. On behalf of my wife, Lauren, my entire family, I just want to say thank you for how you welcomed us and made Tampa our second home. I thank the players for the commitment they had. I thank the Glazers for how they just made everything so special for us and gave us a chance to be successful. And I thank God for allowing me the opportunity to coach the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and make Tampa Bay our home. My entire thought process in coaching was to show people that you could have Christian values and still be successful. And thanks to these young men you see behind me, we were able to do that. Thank you. God bless. It's quite an honor to be in the Buccaneer Ring of Honor. Thank you.